Hey guys, Jessica Kubasi here. I get a lot of questions about how I started in photography, what kind of inspired me, how I got into it, and how I got to where I am today. So it's kind of weird because I actually originated as a graphic designer, really had no background in photography until a couple of years ago, so that's kind of what makes it a little interesting, I guess, not that boring. So for all the people who really know me, you'll know that I came originally from Neopets.com. And that's how I kind of started out, and that was when I was 11 years old. That was when I was introduced to Neopets.com by a friend, and I kind of immediately became obsessed with it. I literally had not a single clue about anything graphic design. I didn't even know how to make a logo. If any of you guys have been on Neopets.com before, they have guilds, and that's kind of what sparked my interest in designing, because there were so many cool guilds with designs. I didn't know how to do any of it. I had to figure it out myself. There was a website. It was called Lisa Explains. Lisa Explains. And it was like my go-to website for learning about design. My first big accomplishment was making my first JPEG logo. So yeah, I was all about the angelfire.com, GeoCities. I had a website named Purple Girl. Don't ask. I was like 11 or 12. I mean, we all do it, right? We connect like a name to like a color, like orange taco. Cause I love tacos. See, the one thing that got me hooked was Neopets.com and their guilds. I was a huge guild-er person. I was all about the guilds. I remember people legit hated on me because every time I opened a guild, their members would leave. And then they all hated me for that. And I'm sorry. It's not like I purposely was like, hey guys, come on over. But I will admit though, it was I should have taken it down a notch because I opened a guild like every 2 weeks. It was like a short lifespan of a guild. I think the best ones lasted like 3 or 4 days and everyone left. Everyone's like, this is boring. So we ended up making guild like every 4 or 5 days. I had the same people like on council, and people used to like be like, why don't you put anyone new on council? I don't know, I was like 15. Seriously, that brings back so much memories. There was a lot of drama on Neopets though. There was a lot of drama. We tried to do like the adoption thing where I put it on another account and then someone stole my pet, which I will never forgive you for. I don't know who has it now, but you know who you are and you know what pet it is. Neopets was quite the adventure. I was well known. I'm not gonna say famous or popular because I never thought of it back then, and I'm not thinking of it right now, of me as a freaking celebrity on Neopets. I mean, come on. That's, yeah, no. Yeah, for those curious, my username on Neopets was xswimx, but it was fun. It was mostly like fun drama. I learned grammar, I learned spelling, design, socializing to an extent. I learned how to make a marquee, which no one uses anymore, but it was really cool back then. That part of my life was a lot of drama, but a lot of learning in itself. Again, I learned to spell really freaking well. My grammar is impeccable because of Neopets and the whole website thing. If you don't have good grammar, you just can't win an argument. So, thank you, Neopets. You know, it's kind of weird seeing where I came from. Neopets is where I started out, and I'm never going to forget that website. That website helped mold me into what I am. I haven't been back in years. And people need to stop asking me about my pet. I'm not going to give my pet up, okay? He's like a rare pet. A couple of my friends on Neopets who may or may not be watching this. Sudo, Ashley, Ethan. Oh my god, he's hilarious. Hans, Linty, you know, you gave me a hard time, but we're still cool, you know? You know, we're cool. You can send me an email sometime. So then how did all this kind of connect into where I am today? Well, from Neopets, people always used to ask me, how did you do this certain effect, like on a layout? So I got this so frequently that I figured, hey, why not just write a tutorial? And after a while, I decided to just buy my own website. And then that's when swimchick.net opened up. That website was pretty successful in my opinion. I mean, yeah, there's a lot of drama on that website too. But I mean, I guess that's what happens when you're like 15, 16, and that's just the age of the internet. Everyone's always fighting with each other over dumb stuff, like, oh, you're using the same font as me. So all the people who knew me from Neopets moved over to the swimchick.net site, and that's where I got most of my following. And on top of that, there was a whole other culture of websites. There was outspokenkate.com, there was saruna.net. There's a couple other big websites, I forgot them all, but those are like the main ones. There's just so many memories there. So I don't know if Liz or Kate are watching this. Hey guys, what's up? Send me a message sometime. You know, we could be friends now. I don't know. I was friends with Liz. I think there was like an underlying rivalry between me and Kate, but I think it's over. I swear. remember there was another guy, his name was Scott Remix. That Nat, he was huge too. There was Murder in Paris, Devil in the Details. God, I remember all those websites. I don't know what happened to them. Any of you guys are from that area, shoot me a message sometime. I probably know your website from way back when. From my website, swimchick.net, I actually used a lot of live journal websites to get my photos to use for my layouts. And it just so happened to be all fashion photography that were on these live journals. There was Photo Decadent and there were Mixologies, which I frequently used. And I would look at a lot of fashion photography editorials through that website, and I would use them in my graphic design. Never really thought twice about it, but it was always in the back of my mind because those were the images that I was drawn to, the fashion editorials. I began using those images for editing, retouching, and even after swimchick.net kind of died out, I still did my graphic designing and I still went for the fashion editorial images. So no matter what, I always went back to the fashion photography editorials. It was not like, hey, I want to use a picture of this tree, how beautiful, or like a flower. So after I entered college, my website kind of died down and I stopped really doing any layouts or website stuff. I stopped blogging, which I used to love to do. People used to like to read my blogs, at least according to them. I laughed at my blogs. I thought they were funny. It wasn't, my blogs weren't like, the sun set upon the cold, dark moon, and then I whisked away, and then I stepped onto the cold grass. My blogs were kind of like, oh my god, my sister eats like a monkey. I just went to the grocery store, and it's like a zoo in there. Man, these people suck. I compared my neighbor's driving to a rocket ship coming out of the driveway, like, she just flew on out of there. He could have launched into the moon from his driving. Frequently mentioned old people, because they're kind of cool. So when I was in college, the whole thing kind of died down. College was kind of like, you think you're here to do graphic design, but you're not. You're actually just gonna put a couple of characters on a page and then just have some old guy critique it and then just be in the mat room all by yourself all night. Oh, and they have really bad cafeteria food there, so it's kind of sucked. Lost a lot of weight that year. But I made a lot of friends from our distaste of the cafeteria. Throughout college, I kind of gave up on my website just a tiny bit. It was a little depressing, I'm not gonna lie, because my website was kind of like my life. I was inside a lot. Thus granting me the nickname Hermit. I mean, I gave myself the nickname right now, but I mean, the Hermit's not a really bad thing, actually. I'm Kermit, and he's on the Muppets. He's famous. And then after I finished college, I didn't really have a design job lined up. I still had my cashier job at Best Buy. A couple months after graduation, I finally got a job at a marketing agency as a junior graphic designer. So now I had a part-time job, which was photography, and then my full-time job, which was graphic designing. It was pretty rough. I mean, I know people were always like, oh, we never see you. You never respond to my text message. I literally woke up with like 50 billion, like I couldn't even scroll anymore. It's like, you've reached your limit. You can't scroll. I'm like, damn, I don't even want to scroll anymore on my phone. I just kind of did it. I didn't really think about it. I just worked a lot. After I ended my job with a marketing agency, I decided to do photography full-time. But just keep in mind, before this, I had been thinking about doing my photography full-time, but I never thought of it as something that I could do full-time. I was always like, there's no way I can do this. I can't make enough money. It's not a stable job. I kept saying it's not stable. It was only when I just felt like, you know, you're just put in the position where you kind of have to just go for it. So I started my photography business. Going into it full time was extremely intimidating. I wasn't happy at a desk job, you know, working 9 to 5, sitting on the computer all day. I just wasn't happy there. I remember even before this, applying to design agencies was just a total nightmare. It's like, I have a file on my computer. It's called redundant cover letter. That's how annoyed I was of writing cover letters to every single different company. Like, hey, I want to be in your company and I think you think that I'm nice. And no, they need cover letters and resumes. And well, here's my blood sample too. Here's a video of me tap dancing. Here's a picture of me and my cat. When I was still in college, I would periodically go on Facebook. I'd see a lot of people posting their photography. And this kind of got me thinking a lot. What could I do if I did photography? Because I absolutely love editing pictures. I love to retouch. I love to color pictures. That's what I like to do because that kind of was like my graphic design background. But the problem was that First of all, I didn't even have a camera. I really had no interest in photography, which is kind of funny because I have been looking at photography for so long. And if you see me now, you'd probably think, like, what do you mean you had no interest in photography a couple of years ago? And I would be like, I really didn't even think of it. So funny story, I actually contacted a photographer friend of mine. I remember thinking, hey, why don't I just edit someone else's pictures and do that as a side job? You know, like if I could retouch or color their pictures and they just pay me. That would be exactly what I want to do. But the problem was that a lot of their pictures weren't really my style. The problem was that I just can't edit something that I'm not inspired by. If it's not my style, my editing is really not going to be that great. So I figured, why don't I just cut the middleman out and I just do that myself? So everything just goes through me. So it'll be like my complete work. I did a little bit of research. I bought my first camera. It was the Canon 60D. I was going to buy the Canon Rebel. That's the one I originally wanted to buy. But I put in a couple extra $100 and I just bought the Canon 60D. I used that for about, I think, a year and a half. I used it on no flash. I didn't even know manual existed, actually, until I contacted another photographer. And he was very nice. He helped me out. He actually let me know about using RAW. I didn't even know about RAW. Man, I'm horrible. I use no flash. After shooting for a year and a half, I decided it was time to upgrade my camera. I upgraded to the Canon 5D Mark II. When I got the camera, it was so funny because I was with my friend Amelia. She's a model, and we were outside shooting. It was my first time using the camera, so I'm so excited. I went to take pictures, and I noticed on the settings that there was no flash mode. And I'm like, okay, what do I do now? There was manual, and there was something else, but manual was like the only one. So I'm like, okay. So now I have to figure out how to do manual, how to use manual now. So that day that I was shooting with her was my like little experimentation thing when I was first starting to use manual. It took me a couple of weeks or even months, I think, to kind of master it, to kind of get it in my head of what I wanted, to be able to switch the settings to each different lighting condition, but I finally got it. It's kind of like a really bad Christmas present, like, here's a new camera. It has absolutely nothing that you know how to do. Have fun. Here's a photo shoot. Go give me 20 pictures. It's going to be published in a magazine. But then again, everything is a learning process. From there on out, I was watching YouTube tutorials constantly. I was researching, as boring as they were. I was reading articles. I was also trying to befriend other photographers. I was just trying to get into the photography community. When I first started with the 60D, I was basically shooting my siblings or friends. I didn't really have much of a portfolio, so I used those images, put them up on Facebook, and kind of started to generate interest in my work. I basically spammed everyone on Facebook. I'm like, here, look at my work. Oh, you missed it? Well, here, I'm uploading the same one 5 minutes later. Okay, but no, I didn't do that, you guys. But I just kind of every so often I would upload a picture, kind of remind everyone, like, hey guys, I exist. Look what I'm doing. But the point was, I was constantly networking, socializing, putting my stuff up. I had an Instagram. I was posting stuff on my Instagram. You really have to be a part of the community. So you gotta get to know people. Through my Facebook page, I had a model contact me to work with me, who has become a very good friend of mine. Her name is Amelia, and we work together a lot now. She first contacted me saying, like, hey, I saw your work. I would love to work with you. So we met up, and that was like my first model testing. You post one picture of a model, and they kind of all know each other. So after that, I started getting other models asking to work with me. And I would ask other models to work with, and I would have a portfolio of images now that I kind of started up. The hardest part was when you're first starting out, no one really knows you. So you have to kind of start at the basics. Senior pictures, family pictures, stuff like that. That's what I would recommend if you're first starting out. This can build your clientele. This can help you network better. And then the people who booked me for family pictures or senior pictures who got engaged would book me for their engagements. And then from engagements, I started to get weddings. So it kind of, oh, it's like a snowball. So that's kind of my journey through photography. It's not really that exciting. It involves being inside a lot, mostly in my basement. But still, it's great. Look where I am now, I guess. Look, there's a window right here, guys. See, I'm looking outside. This is kind of like part of my life right now. I am one with nature. Thank you guys for watching. And if you have any further questions, please let me know. Bye, guys.